If there's one thing space is good at, it's posing for pretty pictures. I'll prove it. Look at these things. Aren't they just beautiful? There's just so many colors. But that makes me wonder, what was the first color? Like, what was the color of the Big Bang? Let's start by setting some ground rules. We'll pretend a human could survive a trip to the beginning of the universe and define color based on what a human eye can perceive, as opposed to, like, dog eyes. We all good here? Okay. So step number one in figuring out the color of the Big Bang, in order to see anything at all, we need photons. Those little packets of light hitting our eyes is the first step in how we perceive color. So if we're hanging out at the beginning of time, we've got to wait until photons come into existence. But luckily, we don't have to wait long. This incredibly early point in our universe's timeline is wildly hard to study. We don't actually have data from that time, just models based on more recent data that scientists then extrapolate backwards. So when our writer reached out to some experts to pin down exactly when the first photons popped into existence, the timelines weren't in perfect agreement. One expert said they appeared no later than 10 to the minus 34 seconds, and another would only say that they appeared sometime between 10 to the minus 43 seconds and 1 second into the existence of everything. But an official CERN website went with that 10 to the minus 43 seconds value, so for the sake of ease, we'll go with that for our number crunching. And now that we have a time, we can estimate a temperature, which might sound like I'm going off on a tangent to get to color, but stay with me. The temperature of the early universe was very closely tied to its age. Specifically, as the universe got older, it got bigger, and as it got bigger, it cooled down. At 10 to the minus 43 seconds, the temperature was roughly 10 to the 26 Kelvin, which is about as hot as 17 sextillion suns. But that's only half as hot as my laptop gets when I'm just trying to lay in bed late at night and watch YouTube videos. Now, as for what the temperature of the universe has to do with the color of the universe, well, it's actually pretty straightforward. The temperature controls the color. This is the basic principle of Planck's law. Coined by the physicist Max Planck in the 1900s, it basically says that the only thing that determines the color of a black body is temperature. Not chemical makeup, nothing else, just temperature. Temperature corresponds to energy, and particles at different energies emit different colors. And to answer that question you almost definitely have swirling around in your brain right now, a black body is an object that emits its own light, but completely absorbs any and all light that tries to reflect off of it. So nothing in existence is a true black body, but it's a pretty good approximation for things like stars or the Big Bang. If you want an example of how all this works, just take a look at our sun. No, don't literally look at the sun, unless, of course, you are wearing our SciShow eclipse glasses to specifically look at a solar eclipse, like the one that will be visible from North America in 2024. For the purpose of this video, just look at this image of our sun. So it looks white, right? Well, it's really a smushed together rainbow of colors, and the amounts of each color it emits are governed by Planck's law. Here's the profile of colors emitted by a black body with the same temperature as our sun's surface. And that peak right there tells us our sun emits more green light than any other color. The Big Bang has its own black body curve too, but if you plug 10 to the 26 Kelvin into the equation for Planck's law, you get a peak that's way over yonder in the gamma ray part of the electromagnetic spectrum. But even though the peak is over there, the curve never actually drops to zero. The Big Bang would have also emitted light that's visible to the human eye. And most of that light would have been violet, followed by blue, then green, and so on. But before we can smush all that light together to get a single perceived color, I just need to take a quick moment to thank our sponsor, Brilliant. Brilliant is an online learning platform with thousands of interactive lessons in science, computer science, and math, and their course Beyond the Nutshell was created in collaboration with fellow YouTube channel Kurzgesagt. So you know it's got great visuals and explanations to make complicated space science a little bit less complicated. Over 8 lessons, this course explores the big questions of astrophysics and cosmology, along with smaller concepts like the limits of humanity. So for one of the most efficient ways to totally blow your mind, you can try Brilliant for free for 30 days at brilliant.org/science. SciShow, or by clicking the link in the description down below. That link will also give you 20% off an annual premium Brilliant subscription. And now let's get back to figuring out the color of the Big Bang. So we've figured out the photons, but now we have to address the nuances of human vision. And of computer monitors. For one thing, every individual person experiences color differently. But in general, humans are better at seeing blue than violet. So the Big Bang might look bluer than it otherwise should, given the actual number of violet and blue photons being emitted. And no two people may agree on the exact shade of periwinkle their brains wind up processing. But even acknowledging all of that, I still can't show you a definitive color, because whatever I'm trying to share with you has to be translated into something your computer understands and then tries to replicate with whatever technology it's rocking inside of its screen. And I don't know what kind of device you're using to watch this video, let alone the color profile settings that you've gone with. If you got one of those blue light remover apps turned on, this isn't gonna work at all. So bearing all of that in mind, this is a rough approximation of the color of the Big Bang. This image is based on numbers crunched by a few people trying to find the color of, quote, infinitely hot. It's not our exact 10 to the 26 Kelvin temperature, but it'll do. However, it's worth noting that the guy who first did this calculation has a disclaimer to not take any of this as very accurate. According to him, there's a lot of nuance in converting a temperature into a perceived color, so there's a lot of room for error. But that's the end of the story, right? We've got a hypothetical color of the Big Bang. Should we have a party? Maybe design some merch? I mean, I could go for a periwinkle t-shirt for sure. Maybe not so fast with that, because I've got some bad news. If you went back in time to watch the Big Bang, you would see nothing at all. It turns out the universe was completely opaque until around 380,000 years after it came into being. At 10 to the minus 43 seconds, you wouldn't be able to see your hand in front of your face, let alone a pretty periwinkle. And by the time you could actually see stuff, the universe would have cooled down to a balmy 3000 Kelvin, which at that point, the universe would look a lot more like a medium-toned household light bulb than a summer sky. Which, for a make-believe time traveler, is probably a pretty big bummer. But, you know, I'm content to just sit back and admire all the colors that the universe has made in the intervening eons, because, you know, they're pretty nice too.